Drew's heading over 300 miles away to Kent. He's visiting a house that's been in the same family for generations.
So we're off to see William Dawes, and they've got this big pad up here. And basically, it has come from shipping money. It's an old Victorian house that's been in the family for about 300 years. And what I'm hoping is that it's one of those houses that's been in the family for so long. Hopefully there's some goodies lying around that have been squirreled away.
The estate of Mount Ephraim is 3 miles east of Faversham and has been looked after by the Dawes family since the 17th century. The house standing here today was built by shipping magnate Sir Edwin Dawes in 1878. It's now run by his great-great-great-grandson, William.
William, Drew, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. How are you doing?
Yeah, very well. So, blimey, look at that.
Yeah,
wow.
The brides love the staircase coming down.
Amazing. That's all cast iron, isn't it? What's unusual is this original finish. So they painted the cast iron to look like wood. The design of the interior of the house is, it's a real melting pot of different styles. Come in and you've got huge cast iron Rococo swirls, and you've got neoclassical columns with sort of Georgian pierced plaster and painted decoration. You find this quite often in English houses where they basically nicked lots of different styles because it showed you had travelled, you'd been around the world, you understood all these different styles. So it's very glamorous, that's for sure.
This is one of our rooms full of old junk.
What I love deeply about coming to these houses is they have their so-called junk rooms. Now, I wish everybody had a junk room like this. They're just great. You go in, you think, look at this, how lucky am I? This is my job, to wander around people's houses and sift through their old stuff. Don't know about you, but I just love it. It just never, ever gets boring. What about that table? It's a chinoiserie card table again. Side table, hopefully it's got a drawer on one side. Yes, it does. It's a nice little side table. So it's a 19th century Chinese export or Japanese export side table. A little bit thick on the leg. Single side, a lot of water damage to the top. Oh, and the caster's just fallen off now.
Have you just bought it?
Chinoiserie refers to the European version of Eastern decoration or design, which became popular in the 18th century. This slightly later example from the 1800s has suffered some water damage, but still has the original paintwork and drawers. It could be worth around £500. Next, Drew wants to check out the basement, where items from the house have been collecting for over 100 years.
Another thing I know of down here is some old ornamental cannons.
Ah, little ones.
Yeah.
Little cannons.
Four or five foot.
Are they on bases?
Yeah, I think wooden bases.
Yep, let's have a look. Oh, yeah.
So they used to sit outside the tea room until they were stolen one time. We obviously got them back, but after that, they've come down here and stayed here.
Oh, great. You got a pair of them?
Definitely two. There might be three.
Really?
Yeah.
You just made my day.
There's
one there.
Yeah, another one there. Here's a third one.
So you've got one pair of these.
Yeah.
And then one odd one.
Yeah.
Blimey. Now, these, again, I think they're a similar cannon to that. Again, and I think these are real cannons. See where they've been sealed up there with lead?
Yeah.
They poured lead into it to stop them being used. Go all the way to the end of the cellar down here, and there are some cannons. And these aren't fake cannons. These aren't lawn cannons. These aren't decorative. These are cannons designed to repel people, kill things, and sink boats. Are they seized? No, it's not seized up. The frames that they're on, they've rotted in a way that's made them very beautiful. And it gives them a huge amount more age than the frames really are. Now, if those frames were in perfect, beautiful condition, I wouldn't like them as much because they wouldn't have the age. That oak, and it is oak, has rotted through, and it takes hundreds of years for a piece of oak to rot like that. I'm extremely excited by these.
These cast iron cannons are genuine 18th century naval guns, mounted on estate-made 19th or early 20th century oak carriages with cast iron wheels. Purchased by one of William's predecessors, they would have been a display of wealth and knowledge of naval warfare. Left outside for more than a century, the bases are very weathered. Once restored, however, they could be worth around £3,000.
How to value them is really tough. Now, if they're a pair of lawn cannon, ornamental lawn cannon, I can value them, that's no problem. Haven't got a clue. That one out there, I think, is worth 600 quid. These ones... What do you think, T?
I think they're bloody heavy.
All right, OK. I'll throw a bid in, £1,000.
For these two?
These two.
And 600?
That one, I'd think I can get 600 out of it, so I'd want to pay a little bit less.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Can we say 500 quid for that one? So 1,500 quid for the three.
Yeah.
That's... Done? Marvellous. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm really, really sorry.
You're not really.
You can shoot me with them afterwards. But that is one of the most unusual purchases we've done in an awful long time.
Never bought anything like that before.
No. Any history that can go with an item should be kept with it. So they've been here an awful long time. We will say this is where they've come from. It will go on the invoice when sold. So hopefully that will stick with them.
The cannons are sent straight to Gav for some much-needed restoration.
Time for the operation.
They can't go on the website until the oak bases have been treated.
All the wood's not rotten, but it's quite old and it's decayed in places and it's all wobbly and the bolts are not doing what they're meant to do, so we're going to put some hardener on them.
Gav starts by treating the bases with wood hardener. Made from extra-strong resin, it soaks down into the wood's core, hardening into a tough layer which protects the wood from further damage.
Is it worth strapping it to get a better lift on it? No, just lift
you really
going to
go there?
No, I can lift it. I'm not bothered about that. You've got the really heavy end.
They call me the guns for nothing.
Yeah, but you fire blanks. On three. One, two, three, go. OK. All right, that's my bit done.
With the cannon's bases hardened, they're then photographed and ready for sign-off from Drew.
I'm particularly pleased with how the restoration's come out. It's more of a conservation job than restoration, and the lads have got it spot on.